Construction of bituminous concrete pavement. In this presentation, we would be discussing on various step-by-step procedures involved in the construction of bituminous concrete pavement. The various steps involved in the construction are preparation of the existing base coat layer, application of tack coat, preparation and placing of premix, rolling, seal coat, quality control of bituminous concrete construction. Next, we'll move on to details of these steps. So, starting with the first step, which is preparation of existing base coat layer. You know that bituminous concrete is usually provided as a wearing coat on existing base coat. So, for this, the existing surface is given some preparations like removing the potholes or the rust, if any, and if the surface contains irregularities, it is filled with premix chippings, and this is done at least a week before laying the surface. Now, if the existing pavement is extremely weak, then a bituminous leveling course of adequate thickness is provided to lay the bituminous concrete surface course on the binder course instead of laying it directly on the base course, which is the water bound macadam. Moving on to the second step, which is application of tack coat. It is usually desirable to lay an asphalt concrete layer over a bituminous base or binder coat. Now, the tack coat is applied over the prime coat so that an adhesive bond is formed between the prime coat provided and the next layer of coating. And usually the tack coat is provided to prevent the slippage, and it can also function as a long-term sealer to protect the substrata from moisture and bacteria. The base coat of bitumen is usually applied at a rate of 6 to 7.5 kg per 10 meter square area. And if you are using a non-bituminous base, then this quantity is increased to 7.5 to 10 kg. The third step, preparation and placing of premix or the bituminous mix. Now, the premix is prepared in hot mix plants of required capacity with the desired quality control. Here, the bitumen is heated up to 150 to 177 degrees Celsius and then aggregates are added to it. Now, when you add the aggregate, it's always ensured that the temperature of aggregate do not differ by more than 14 degrees Celsius from the binder temperature. Once the mix is ready, the hot mixed material is collected from the mix with the help of transporters, and it is carried to the location, and at the location or the site, it is spread with the help of mechanical pavers at a temperature of 121 to 163 degrees Celsius. And when you spread the bitumen, the premix, the accuracy of camber and thickness of layer are always verified. Now, when the entire process is done, always the temperature is kept under control during the mixing as well as compaction process, because the variation or the temperature has a great influence on the strength of resulting pavement structure. Moving on to the fourth step, which is rolling. That is, after the mix is placed on the base coat, it is thoroughly compacted by rolling at a speed not more than 5 km per hour. Now, this rolling is done in three stages. The initial rolling or static rolling is done by 8 to 12 ton rollers. Then an intermediate rolling is done with a fixed wheel pneumatic roller of 15 to 30 ton having a tire pressure of 7 kg per centimeter square. Now, when you do the rolling, the wheels of rollers are always kept damp with water so that it do not peel the bottom layer. Now, the number of passages given depends on the thickness of layer. After that, the final rolling is done by 8 to 10 ton tandem rollers. Now, if the rolling is done in weather, warm weather conditions, rolling on next day helps to increase the density if the initial rolling was not adequate enough. this is the rolling process, and you can also see the tandem rollers which is used for this process. Moving on to the next step, which is seal coat. Now, seal coat is the final coat which is applied during construction to a bituminous macadam or concrete for sealing the surface of pavement. And the seal coat is a mix of sand with bitumen. It is spread on the road to plug the voids, and final rolling is provided with 8 to 10 tandem rollers. Once you complete the seal coat, the finished surface is checked to ensure few of the features, and this checking is done with the help of a 3-meter straight edge, and it is checked that the longitudinal undulations does not exceed 8 mm and the number of undulations higher than 6 mm should not exceed 10 in a length of 300 meter, and the cross traffic profile should not have undulations exceeding 4 meter. Now, once all these processes are complete, we move on to the quality control of bituminous concrete construction. So the routine checks are carried out at the site to ensure the quality of the resulting pavement mixture and the pavement surface. Periodical checks are made for aggregate grading, grade of bitumen, temperature of aggregate, temperature of paving mix during mixing and compaction. Now, at least one sample for every 100 tons of the mix discharge by the hot mix plant is collected and tested for the above requirements. Sometimes Marshall test is also carried out. Now, for every 100 meter square of the compacted surface, one test of field density is conducted to ensure that it is within 95% of density obtained in the laboratory. The variation in thickness allowed is 6 mm per 4.5 meter length of construction. With this, we come to the end of this presentation. Thank you.